The 1950s and 1960s are called the Golden Ages for a reason. They produced some of the finest actors, musicians, and artists in history. In today's video, we are going to be looking at the life of Jeanette Munro, one of the finest actresses that ever lived, and her tragic death while she was at the peak of her career. But before we go on, here's a challenge for you. Like this video and subscribe to this channel, then go to the comment section and comment, "I subscribed," to win a shout out from us. Done? Let's go. Born Janet Nielsen Horsburgh on September 28, 1934, to Alex Munro, a Scottish stage comedian, and Phyllis Robertshaw. Although she was born in Blackpool, Lancashire, Janet spent most of her childhood on the road with her dad, and was often seen on stage with him. At the age of 7, tragedy struck, and little Janet lost her mother. She was thus raised by her father, who took her everywhere. She later recalled wearing kilts and singing in her tiny little voice to entertain the troops during the war. Her voice may have been tiny, but the soldiers loved her performance as she strongly reminded them of home. She was there because her father was head of the entertainment for the RAF, and she, as usual, had to be wherever he was. At the age of 10, she moved to the town of Emsey to live with her aunt and uncle for a while, and went back to live with her father when he remarried. She was thus raised by her dad and stepmother. She had always wanted to be an actress, and even while she was working at a shoe shop after graduation, she still maintained her stance. She later said, "I never had any doubt as to what I wanted to be." She, however, wanted to be not just any actress, but a legitimate actress to form a career of her own. So when her father invited her to join him and share his stage, she declined. She went on and got a job with a repertory company as a student messenger, and got the opportunity to learn on the job. "I learned as I went along, playing bits, and by the time I was 17, I was stage manager for the company." Pretty impressive for a teenager. Her job required her to travel a lot, taking her to towns like Preston, Oldham, and Hull, with a weekly wage of about £8. She began appearing on TV in 1954, with an appearance on the BBC TV adaptation of I Capture the Castle, where she played the lead part of Rose. Then she went on to play a small role in the comedy film Small Hotel in 1957, and became in regular British TV shows such as Armchair Theatre and a few other small films. In 1958, she was named Miss English Television, a big win for a budding actress. Her big break came in March 1958, when she was offered a role as the lead actress in Walt Disney's Darby O'Gill and the Little People. It was an even bigger break when she won the Golden Globe Award for the Most Promising Newcomer for her role in this movie. Not many people have won that. Despite the fact that the movie was shot in Hollywood, most of its cast were English, including its lead actors. Disney had spotted her in Pick Up Girl and invited her for a screen test, which lasted for 2 days, before giving her the role. He was so impressed by her that he signed her to a 5-year contract after the movie. Right after her first movie, she was cast in yet another major one in the same year. She was fast becoming a sensation. She made her debut in the US film industry by appearing in a TV adaptation of Berkeley Square for American anthology TV program Hallmark Hall of Fame. It is the longest running primetime series in the history of television and is still running now, 69 years after it first aired. I wonder how many episodes that amounts to. Munro was sought by both the UK and the US's film industries, and continued alternating between the UK and the US, featuring in major movies that shot her career through the roof. Munro is married to an English film actor, Tony Wright, but like most celebrity marriages, this one didn't last. They were married for just 3 years, from 1957 to 1959, and they had no children. In 1963, she got married again to Ian Hendry, a former Avengers star, with whom she had 2 children, Sally and Corey Hendry. She left the acting scenes to take care of her 2 children and set her home right. But this too didn't last so long, and 8 years later, it broke down. Reason was due to Hendry's unreasonable behavior. Henry didn't try to refute this accusation, so I think we can all agree he was indeed the reason for the breakup. Val Guest, one of the directors Munro had worked with, stated, "Janet's life was a disaster. She didn't become an alcoholic until she met Ian. She tried too hard to keep up with him. Her life was indeed a disaster. She had suffered 2 miscarriages in her marriage with Hendry. She developed an addiction to alcohol in the same marriage. She was depressed and had several medical problems, one of which consequently claimed her life. Generally, she led a grossly unhappy life." That was in sharp contrast to how she appeared in public and the roles she had to play. The curtains were drawn a bit too early on Munro's life, as she left this world at the age of 38. Reports have it that she choked to to death while drinking tea due to an attack of acute myocarditis, and the underlying cause was a chronic heart disease. While some reports say she died in the hotel where she was drinking the tea, others say she died on her way to the hospital. Either way, we know it was her heart that opened the portal into the afterlife for her. Her body was cremated and interred at the Golders Green Crematorium. And that brings us to the end of today's video. Tell us how much you enjoyed this video on a scale of 1 to 10 in the comment section below. And do not forget to leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more amazing content. See you next time, folks!